what it was when they asked me to do it. So
when were you asked that for example?
We are a week ago, I think. Maybe a little bit more, maybe 10 days ago. When I got down here, I got a little bit panicked. I was like, this place is huge. We did some projects, and we were just to keep it moving and make sure there weren't too many gaps or too many sort of mishaps. But it was tough, man. There's like 4,000 people out
there.
What was your favorite part of playing?
The writing, I think. Both Matt Nix and Alfredo Barrios. They obviously created the character, and they were so open with me about what it would be. And so they really, really, I can honestly tell you, did such an amazing job on writing that character that it was so easy for me to play. So, and you don't always get that. It's very special. No, they're the best ones to play.
They're the best ones.
Well, he's a sociopath, so, you know, he
not at all.
He's got no guilt, no remorse, none of the normal human conditioning that that any of us here have, and that's what makes it fun. So when you open up those darker sides of the human condition, a lot of it's funny, you know, or a lot of it's entertaining at least. A lot of it's very painful, and you get that mix. You get that, you know, sad versus joyous versus anything.
So it's kind of hard. I mean, is it usual on shows that you guys kind of have directors also playing a role in this space? I'm not too sure about that.
I've heard of it. So, I'm sure there are many other actors on television that do direct in their own shows. I don't know how many films they've directed.
Especially two of them.
Yeah. But Larry's such a great guy. Yeah. He makes things very easy. And when he's directing, of course, he does have his director's hat on. So it's kind of different. Well, it's not like you're acting with another actor.
It's not the two of them.
Yeah, yeah, that's right.
Physicality of the role playing
in your life. Well, I tried to sort of step away from the cliche macho spy type of bad dude, and one of the ways we embraced that, and I brought it to Matt and Alfredo, and they thought it was a great idea, was to give Gilroy, you know, a very effeminate, well-cultured, sort of delicate nature, external look and feel. And in doing that, if you keep that side of it lighter, you can bring so much of the darker side through that, which we thought was very interesting, rather than being trying to be too macho and then dark. There's a sort of protocol there. It's always, the stunt guys are so good in the industry generally, in particular in Burns, that any of the stuff that you have to be seriously trained for, they will do that. There'll be body doubles and they always ask you as an actor how far you're willing to go, how much you're willing to learn, and they put safety first. So if they think you're being capable of doing a particular stunt and no one's going to get hurt, then you're good to go.
So what's your answer to that?
That's my answer to it. I'll go just about anywhere. I'll jump up anything. At the end of the day, it comes down to
what space when you've done for Bernard so far that you've actually done yourself?
I didn't get to do many because I was kind of delicate. We were just talking about that. So Gilroy doesn't get his hands dirty. He gets other people to get their hands dirty and jump out of buildings and stuff. He sort of directs it a little bit more. As an actor, I guess some of the other stunts I did in various shows, Prison Break, particularly, were crazy. Helicopters, all sorts of blowing up stuff. I was always getting a lot of that. It was a lot of fun.
So, ask Gilroy, what did you think of each of the characters? What was your thoughts? What was Sam in Gilroy's eyes?
I think one predominant thing, I think Gilroy fell in love with Michael Weston. I think he fell in love with Michael Weston, and if you're going to take it that far, I think he was perhaps a little bit jealous of Larry, because obviously they have an ongoing relationship. And I'm sure Gilroy wanted much, much more, but then he was, well, no. it's one out.
So I'm not sure how much is planned for this movie that was literally just announced a few minutes ago, but do you know if you're going to have a part in that, or?
I don't know. I'll be told if I do. I don't like to ask those things because there's so many decisions that go into it, and there's so much pressure on the creators and the writers and everybody else that, if they feel there's a place for me, then they'll let me know. I'd be delighted if you do it, but I never asked those scripts.
What do you have coming up?
What do I have coming up? I'm doing an episode of Face and Feet next week in Toronto. I'm playing an ex-rock star who's dying. It's all very fun. And I'm in the middle of the development process with one of the studios here to create my own series, or a series that I haven't created myself. So that takes a long time. No, I can't say who it's attached to. Just from a personal point of view, that's generally what I'm
doing.
Are we good?
All right, I think that's it. For-